What's up guys, this is Hal Hart back with another video. Before we get started, make sure you hit that like button and subscribe for more video content. In this video, we'll be continuing with the Lat Lon tools. So now that we've done the multi-location zoom, let's look at the next thing, which is our coordinate conversion. So the coordinate conversion, let's click on that, brings up this cool dialog box with all these confusing terminology, but let's go through it really quick. The first thing at the top, you can modify the order. Of course, I think everything in Lat Lon allows you to switch the orders. If you need to clear the form, you can clear it here. There are also settings we'll look at later. This is zoomed to a specific coordinate. This is capture a coordinate. So we have decimal degrees, project CRS, we know that's our reference system. We have DMS, DM.MM, we have DDMMSS, standard UTM, MGRS, plus code, and geohash. So let's run through these really quick, really briefly. All right, so decimal degrees, what in the world does that mean? Let's go ahead and capture a coordinate so we'll have kind of like an example in here so you'll understand what it means or what it looks like. Let's capture a random coordinate and it automatically fills the form for all of these formats, right? So a decimal degree is a degree, so this is 34 degrees, but behind the decimal it gets more specific. So this is 34, but it's 0.16975666, right? It's really, really specific. And that's the same with lat and longitude. The next thing is the CRS extent, the X and the Y extent here. And then we come down and we see that we can manipulate our CRS here with our drop-down box. We see that we have the DMS. What in the world is that? Well, that stands for degrees, minutes, and seconds. So if you look down here in this format, 34 degrees, so we know that's 34, 10 minutes, 11.1240 seconds, all right, to the north. Now, if we look to the next one, DM.MM, what is this M.MM? Well, that is decimal minutes, okay? So this is a minute, but behind the decimal is it's pretty much the seconds. All right, so it says 34 degrees, 10 minutes, okay? And then the decimal for these seconds, this 11.1240, these seconds right here are put into the decimal part of the minute. So I mean the calculation or the format is representing the same value. The next thing is DDMMSS. This is without delimiters. So there's no spaces or no degree marker or no quotation. It's just 34, 10, and then you can see the 11.1240, same thing, just a different format. Now you have the standard UTM. What in the world is a UTM? Well, that is a universal transverse Mercator. And then you have your MGRS, that is the military grid reference system, military grid reference system code or value. Then you have the plus code. Now the plus code, it works wherever you are for locations that do not have an address. So let's say if you're on like a mountaintop and you need to tell someone, hey, I'm at this location, but there's no address. A plus code is used in this moment to give pretty much a pinpoint to your location that has no address. All right, the next one is the geohash. Geohash, all right. So the geohash is basically a compression of data that is specific to a specific location. So the geo hash, the string that you see here, is representing a specific location. The longer the string, the more specific the location. The shorter the string, the less specific the location. So let's say if we have a really short geo hash, we may be able to get within a few kilometers or maybe a few kilomiles from the location. But the longer the geo hash, the more specific, the more pinpoint we can get on the location. All right, so hopefully I described those where you can understand them. If not, if you have any questions, let me know in the comment section. But let's continue. If you need to copy any of these to your clipboard, there are buttons for that. You can copy any of these to your clipboard. Let's say that you made a mistake. You're going through with your coordinates or with any of these formats and you made a mistake. You want to correct it. You correct it in one of these boxes, but you don't want to have to correct it in all of them. Well, that's what these little green check marks are for. It will convert all of the boxes to the box that you have corrected. So let's say if I put in the wrong coordinate, all I need to do is type in the right coordinate, press the check mark, and all of the formats will align to it. I think we looked at everything except the settings. So let's go to the settings. In your converter, we get the CRS manipulation. We have the order manipulation, but now we can specify precisions in our values. Okay, so you don't have to have like 8 digits behind the decimal point or whatever. You can be very specific with your precision and the delimiters used in your coordinate pairs. All right. Also, you can add spaces between your DMS. You can add multiple spaces, 2 or 3 spaces in here. You can take all the spaces out, whatever you want to do here. You can also pad your DMS, all right, with different spaces. Again, if you have any questions, comments, leave them in the comments section. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. And as always, I will see you in the next one. Peace.